Okay, but as you set goals, as you believe in yourself, challenges will come along the way. Challenges will come along your way. Michael Jordan says this: if you're trying to believe, there will be roadblocks. I've had them, everyone's had them. But obstacles don't have to stop you. If you run into a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure out how to climb it, go through it, or work around it. Figure out how to climb through it, climb over it, go through it, or work around it. What are the challenges in your life? Okay, what are they? Oh yeah, sorry, I forgot to mention here, the negative people. Write them down. Who are the people that are always negative, that always drag you down? Write them down, and then decide afterwards to let it wash off you. So don't avoid them, because you can't avoid family members that drag you down. You can't avoid friends that drag you down sometimes, all right? You can't avoid people at tournaments that are going to drag you down. So you need to learn how to take it and let it wash off. Take it, guard your heart with all diligence, okay? Guard your heart, guard those thoughts, and let it wash off you. So write them down, write all those people down, and then kind of make a pre-decision that when they speak negatively to you, that you're not gonna listen. Okay, so do that. So challenges will come your way. Challenges like negative people. Challenges like not believing in yourself. But for me, a big challenge was knee operations, okay? I trained hard, I trained stupidly, and I got my first knee operation, I was 18 or 17, my next one I was 18, my next one I was 19. I had 5 knee operations by the time I was 21. I had 1 knee reconstruction and 5 meniscus cutouts or stitches, okay? So my knees are pretty shot, all right? And it caused problems, okay? So leading into the Beijing Olympics, my main rival was a guy from Sydney who was very, very good. Really tight game. And he was always stronger than me. And I was small, under 60 kilos. I weighed about 64, so I used to cut weight. And I could bench like 85 maybe. Then I had my knee reco. I was out for 13 months. The surgeon said 12 months. This is back in 2007, 2008. No, 2004, 2005. I've had so many knee operations, I get confused. And of which one's which. But I had a full 13 months off training. And for a guy that trained twice a day, 6 days a week, it's pretty tough. When you couldn't make trips and tournaments that you got selected for, but sorry, I'm injured, I can't go. Then you go down on the selections on the national table, you get no funding, okay? So you need funding to do trips overseas and all that sort of stuff. So massive, massive blow, okay? Challenges, maybe no money. How are you gonna work around it? I had 3 jobs. I worked at the fun factory, I gardened my boss's house, and I worked at a service station, a gas station, okay? So I had 3 jobs. What are you doing to work around it? So for me, had the knee reconstruction, what could I do? I'm not that strong, I didn't get strong. So I switched to a bodybuilding program and I got jacked. I went up to like 72 kilos. I could bench 115 for 1 rep and I could rep about 105. I could rep 160 kilo deadlift and I did 1 rep of 180. So I got way strong. Then when I had to come back to judo, I switched my program to a strength-based program. I lost all the muscle that I put on, but I kept the strength. So I went from benching 115 to about 110, 1 rep. So I lost a little bit of max strength because I didn't have the bulk to kind of help it out, but I got way stronger. And when I came back to training, and then every night I'd lay in bed and I'd do 100 moves. I'd do 100 shoulder throws in my head, 100 osotogaris, or, you know, for jiu-jitsu, I'd do 100 triangles, do 100 arm bars. 100 double legs, just thinking about it, laying in bed, thinking about it, doing mental imagery. Then when I came back to training, I was wrecking people. And my training partners were saying, Matt, you've had 13 months off. It feels like you haven't like had a week off, because I was so strong. I was so fit. Then I came back and that guy beat me by a little bit. Steven beat me by a little bit. Then he beat me by a little bit less. Then he beat me by a little bit less. That guy who I said was my main rival. And then I finally beat him. Then I beat him for the Olympics. But it was all because I was stronger. But I still didn't beat him straight away, but I chipped away at it. So, like I said, what for me, injuries were a big one. What are the challenges in your life that what you need to work around, okay? And sometimes when I go to schools and people say, oh, I really want to make the Australian swimming team, but my parents don't, believe in me, or I want to become a they don't believe in me. So I tell people that you don't tell people your goals, you show them your goals. You don't tell people you want to make the Olympics, you show them you want to make the Olympics or become a black belt by how you live your life. So I know a guy who used to work at the gym. I worked at a gym where there was a swimming pool. This guy, the gym would open at 6, but the pool would open at 5 for all the swimmers. And he was always waiting for the gym to open. And I said to him, why are you here every morning at 6 a.m.? And he said, my daughter told me I want to make the Australian team for swimming. So I told her, well, they train at 5 o'clock every day. I'm not waking you up. Either you wake me up and I'll take you to the pool, but if you don't wake me up, I'm not taking you to the pool. He goes, it's been 5 years. She wakes up every day at 5 o'clock and wakes me up and I have to drive her here, so I may as well exercise while I'm here. But there's an element of she showed him, I want to make it by doing these things. Sometimes people say to me, I really want to do this and do that. I'm like, well, you don't even come to training. How can you win the next tournament when you don't even come to training? Like, show me you want to win the tournament by coming to training all the time. Okay, so show people your goals. Because that's if one of the challenges is people aren't believing in you. It's because you might not be showing them that you're worth believing in. Okay? So when I help people in different areas, that's why I said, oh, what do you want to work on? I want to work on X-Guard. Cool, who have you been watching in X-Guard? I haven't watched anyone. Well, you'll show me you want to work good on X-Guard when you're watching Michelle Nicolini and all these other X-Guard specialists. You'll show me that you want to get good at it by showing me, by researching it yourself. You're showing me. Okay? So COVID-19's here. That's the challenge at the moment, is we can't train. So what are you doing to get stronger, fitter, faster, more knowledgeable? Like I said, for me, I'm watching Reverse Delahiva, the Mendez brothers, and all these guys to kind of get good at these positions to get a deeper understanding of it. I have some friends who want to learn German, some learning Japanese. Okay, but what are you doing in COVID-19? That's a challenge. What are you going to do? What skill are you going to learn? What are you going to get a deeper understanding of? You run an academy? What have you been really slack with at your academy? Is it culture? Is it takedowns? Okay, that you're not really that familiar with, and spend this time to improve yourself somehow.